Good morning, everyone. I greet you in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Today we are here to celebrate the life of our Liam Cadogan, known as Brother Bob. Amen? Amen. Glory to God. So at this time I want to start our service. Morning, and with me is Pastor Errol Daniel. I welcome him this morning. Glory to God. Praise the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Weeping may endure for night, but joy comes in the morning. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Glory to God. Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. Let not your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled. Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. My grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in weaknesses. Praise the name of the Lord. We are here this morning to honor the service of our late brother this morning. Today we have gathered in honor and memory of Mr. Liam Cadogan, better known as Brother Bob. Glory to God. We are here to give God thanks for his life today. We are here to give God the praise that due unto his name this morning. Glory to God. And at this time, I want to ask Pastor Daniel to open with a word of prayer.
Can we stand, please? Prayer is so very important at all times, and especially at this time as we bow before our Heavenly Father. Dear Lord, we thank you for the privilege that you have given unto us to be here to celebrate the life of the departed soul. We thank you, Lord, that we can magnify you even as we look at death, because we know that death doesn't have the final say. We pray especially for the wife and children and the rest of the family, that you'd help them, though they may weep, they will not weep like those who have no hope. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, who is Lord, we just thank you for everyone who has come to this service today. Those who are not right just as yet with you, we pray that they would make their calling and their election sure. For it is a fact that everyone is for a time. Everything is for a time, and time is for a time. But Lord, when the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, when the morning breaks eternal bright and fair, when his chosen ones are gathered to their homes beyond the sky, Lord, help us to know that when the roll is called up yonder, we shall be there. So the message that is given out today in this homegoing service, let it be clear. And let Heavenly Father, those who hear it, accept it. May your power, the power of your Holy Spirit, just bless us in a very special way. Bless the pastor and others who will preside. In Jesus' wonderful name. Amen. Bless
you. Praise the name of the Lord. Our first hymn this morning, oh how great thou art. Amen. How great thou art this morning.
Yeah. praise the name of God. That is kind of our first scripture reading at this time. Amen. Praise the name of
God. 52 to 57. It will happen in a moment, in the blink of an eye, when the last trumpet is blown. For when the trumpet sounds, those who have died will be raised to live forever, and we who are living will also be transformed. For our dying bodies must be transformed into bodies that will never die. Our mortal bodies must be transformed into immortal bodies. Then when our dying bodies have been transformed into bodies that will never die, this scripture will be fulfilled. Death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? For sin is the sting that results in death, and the law gives sin its power. But thank God, He gives us victory over sin and death through our Lord Jesus Christ. Here ends the scripture reading.
So we have a hope today, amen?
Amen.
Glory to God. Our next hymn gonna be, can it be? Hallelujah. Stand again with me this morning. Can you stand this morning? Let us sing and worship the Lord. Hallelujah.
I'm not so very good at it. Would you please help me?
I have chosen an intercessory of love, gathering on me cause
it's
your
love,
your
love,
the name of the Lord. Our second scripture reading at this time. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Good morning. The second scripture reading is taken from Ecclesiastes 3, verse 1 to 9. To everything there is a season, a time to every purpose under heaven, a time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, a time to pluck what is its planting, a time to kill, a time to heal, a time to break down, and a time to build up, a time to weep, a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones, a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get, and a time to lose, a time to keep, and a time to cast away, a time to rend, and a time to sow, a time to keep silent, and a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time of war, and a time of peace. What profit hath he that walketh in that wearing he laboureth? Here ends the scripture reading. Thanks be to God.
Can we have a special song at this time?
Praise the name of the Lord.
Good morning, everybody.
Hide me now under your wings. Cover me within your mighty hands. When the ocean rises and thunder throws, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still, know you are God. I will be still, know you are God. Find rest, my soul, in Christ alone. Know His power in quietness and trust. When the ocean rises and thunders roar, I will soar with you above. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still, know you are God. I will be still, know you are God. When the ocean rises and thunders roar, I will soar with you above. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still, know you are God. I will be still, know you are God.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord. At this time, we have David, Dark Media, that the sign, the Jesus.
Good morning. There is greatness in simplicity. But I would like to turn that around a little bit and say there is usually simplicity in greatness. We are here to take home the remains, the mortal remains of Brother Bob. Let us keep it in that circle. How the Brother Bob came about, I was told a story, but it is a story that I'd rather not repeat in public. Only to say though that Brother was a comedian, and if anybody in this life could recognize a comedian, it would be me. And all of us who live and grew up in Zion Hill, where Brother was from, and had interacted with them, Brother Bob would have left us with something that we would laugh about. He had this unique ability to turn serious situations into laughable situations. And it doesn't take an ordinary person to do that. You have to have something special. And that's what I mean when I say there is simplicity in greatness. But Brother, what Brother stood for, what Brother was capable of doing, did not end with his wild wits. I say wild because he was always doing and saying something that would make you feel the situation is funny. Brother had a lot, from my understanding of firsts. In the days when steel bands were pan around the neck, so you had to wear your instrument around your neck and play it, Brother became, from what I understand, the very first person to play a six-piece bass in a competition. He was not the first to play it. And I want to believe that the other person, well, the band in Zion Hill, whom us as little boys simply called Juicy Steel Band, that the first two men to have played that instrument was members of Juicy Steel Band. That was David Alexander, and Brother succeeded David as the six-band player. But David never played it in a competition. Brother was first to do that. And that is a huge achievement, because Brother possessed an uncanny musical ability. Apart from Pan, I never heard him play any other instrument. But I have a feeling that he would have been, if not good, reasonably competent at playing the instruments of the day, quattro and guitar and those kinds of instruments. Because his ear for music was acute. And many times I would go across by the barber's residence where Juicy Steel Band used to practice, And brother would be standing outside. He would not be the instrument. He would be standing outside and he would come, go inside when he hears something. Now the rest of us who are listening didn't hear it. He heard something that should not have been played, and he will go inside and he will stop the band and he will rectify it. That is a special gift from the Most High. And brother wasted no time in displaying that special gift. Brother moved through many gyms as a bodybuilder. And in talking with him, you would hear about Freddie Ballantyne. He went to Freddie's gym, the McConney family. He used to go there with the McConney son, Lloyd. The older persons in here would know where the McConney residence is. The younger ones, it's where Warren Knight's apartment building is, right next to the Panyard. The McConney family lived there. And in the downstairs of that house was a gym belonging to their son. And brother frequented that gym. Of course, the Ballantyne gym. And several others. So in 1965, when brother was asked or selected to represent St. Vincent at the Mr. Caribbean bodybuilding competition, he was reluctant to go because he had not yet won a local competition. It was always a ding-dong struggle between the likes of Winston, John, and brother, and one or two others who were in prominence in the bodybuilding business in St. Vincent. Eventually, the Ballantynes were able to convince him to take the trip to San Juan, Puerto Rico. And brother went. We knew of the results the next morning. There wasn't really a radio station in St. Vincent then, except WIBS. But early in the morning, most families who had radios would wake up to the sound of Radio Guardian, which is a Trinidad station. And that's where, in the 7 o'clock news, we heard that a man named Leon, brother Bob Cadogan, had won the Mr. Caribbean bodybuilding competition. Now, when I look at pictures from that competition, brother looked skinny among the others. He looked like an ordinary person. And then when I read the Express newspaper, the reporter was saying that they have never seen a body as chiseled. You know when a sculptor takes a hammer and a chisel and chisel out something? They have never seen a body like that. And that's where brother's advantage lied. Ordinarily, you may recognize the fact that he is a bodybuilder, but you may barely recognize it if you see him walking down the road. But then when he takes off those bigger clothes that he used to wear, and he is bareback, and especially in competitions, you have to grease up your skin and all of that. And by the time he had done that and started to pose, That was it for the Requiens. Requiens was this very famous bodybuilder from St. Lucia. He was in that competition. A Barbadian man named Darcy Beckles was the favorite. But the chiseled body of Brother Bob put them all to stand in the back, and Brother and St. Vincent reigned supreme. And that began a journey for Brother in local bodybuilding that lasted 11 plus years until he decided to call it quits. The other persons who in St. Vincent were being spoken about on a regular basis, when they got onto that platform and they started to pose, all of them just faded in the back. Brother Bob reigned supreme. That, again, is a sign of greatness. Despite all of that, and unlike what is happening in the modern setting, Brother never made a big thing about him being Mr. Caribbean or him being Mr. St. Vincent. And for him, winning a second regional competition that was much smaller and didn't and never really got the kind of publicity than the one in Puerto Rico got a few years prior. But he also won a second regional competition right here in St. Vincent, Mr. West Indies. He took it all in his strides. He never got up there and boasted about himself and his achievements. But I believe that is what is inherent in his personality. Brother's mother and my mother are first cousins. And people tell me all the time that I have achieved many things in the theater field in St. Vincent. I do not have to go about boasting about myself. Whatever you hear about Darky, you would hear it from somebody else. You will not hear it from Darky. Because I think it is vain for one to be walking up and down boasting about themselves. And Brother, being a close relative, perhaps it is something in the Cadogans. Actually, I should have been carrying Cadogan. But fate will have it that I took my father's name. I'm going to have to go and take out a deed pool for that. But it's a possibility. But Brother was one of those humble, very humble. Even when Brother is making his white cracks, his face is as innocent and as mundane as you want to see a face. And it's just the effects of the words that will make you crack up. That's the personality of Brother. There are a lot of things that sometimes people write in eulogies that do not have a place in the eulogy. But I think Brother's family took him in stride. They savored what they could savor from his fame. And they encouraged him, egged him on, from my own knowledge, onto what his next goal would be. very supporting family, as we can see. And I'm sure those who cannot make it here would be patting and hugging the others who are here, who are saying this final farewell to someone that I consider a great man, but a simple person. And with that, I would like to say to the family, keep the faith. He was at the point where we expected him to pass at any time. He was down for a couple of years, but we expected that. So even though you mourn, remember you are mourning for a simple yet great individual. Ladies and gentlemen, my tribute to brother, both as a Vincentian icon and as a family member.
Praise the name of the Lord. At this time, I'll to tribute at this time. To tribute at this time. Anyone want to come forward and say something about their brother Bob? Two minutes.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I know brother Bob by my husband, just ask for Kodogan. As the gentleman said, the Kodogan family is a loving family. But as I get into my husband and we get married, I get to know most of the Kodogan families. Anything I have any function, I always will be here with him. But brother Bob's, people talk a lot about brother Bob. And I meet him one time down the road and say, I want to go home, but I don't. I can't. No man be fond of them. So I say, go side away, see going home. I say, all right, I'll get a van and I'll carry up where the bus stop and I'll put you in the van will drop you, with five, drop you to home. He said, all right, thank you very much. But he didn't remember who I be. So I tell him, I am the Kodogan, I am Asko Kodogan wife. So he said, all right, thank you very much. So I put him in the van and I head for down the road. When I go down the road, I meet my husband. I tell my husband, I said, just be brother about me. And he said, yes. He said, what do you think? I said, okay, not too long. He said, all right, nice. But when he said, I meet the Kodogan family, and it was nice. And first, as I got into the Kodogan family, okay, I said, well, there's bad families. There's loving families. Except his sisters and his brothers and them, because he passed on this month, this year, and as he passed on, the friend after he died, they helped me out a lot. So right now, they're rallying me right down. And I have my children and I just say, follow me right now, because as he's gone, I have no husband, I just say, and my mom died last year, so I have no mom neither, no dad. But I have to thank the Lord for sparing my life, for see each moment of my life. As a Kodogan family, we lose brother back, but still, they have life still. They still have a rally on each one of them. Because since my husband died, I just say, me and my sisters and my mom died, but since my mom died, we are closer to one another. So even if you have a family die, and they say, though down on our days, just lift up the spirit. You have Christ in your life. Every morning, thank your spirit, like I say, each day, because you don't know what happened to you next time, because it could be you next time. So each moment of your life, I have to thank you, because I always tell them, my friend, I love that the Kodogan family is nice. They're real friendly, but tell a friend. Once I meet them, we try out be there now. All of Saint Hills, all about when he went in and he used to go in. So each moment, as though he died and gone, just still live up to Christ and give all the life better to Christ, and I will see all of you will be better.
Good morning, everyone.
First of all, let me express my deep condolences to the family of Brother Bob and to the entire Sandhill community. You know, it seems like I'm going to so many funerals in such a short space of time these days. And as I said on a previous occasion, every funeral I attend helps me to put my own life in serious perspective. I am going to say something that may not necessarily resonate very well with a lot of people, but I'm extremely disappointed that a former national representative, a man who represented St. Vincent and the Grenadines in sports, in bodybuilding, throughout the region, is not getting the recognition that he deserves. I know people are going to vex with me, and I ain't talking politics, but it's time enough. You know, this is a man, there's no politician more important than him when it comes to representation. You know? So, but I know the family is a very humble family, and I know you guys don't expect and look forward to those things, but I am saying it. I could afford to say it. We have to do better than that. And the ones who are still with us, our people who put their lives on the line, who put their time, their effort to represent us in whatever capacity, let us give them the recognition that is due. Because it's not easy in societies such as ours, where we are so closely knit, we are always under constant scrutiny and criticism. And for somebody to get the courage and the discipline to represent the country, I think we ought to really recognize that and show that recognition. I know that Brother Bob has created a serious impact in the Sandhill community. When I first met Ronald many years ago, I knew him from before, and I came back and I saw this big, I'm like, who's this guy? Who's this big guy? And he said, well, hey, now, he come from a bodybuilding family. So I think you got to get back into the bodybuilding and carry on Brother Bob's legacy, you know? But I want to say again, my deep condolences to the family. And again, let's use this occasion. I know death is a time for mourning and grieving and sadness and so on. But our life has to continue. And let us take the positives from Brother Bob's life to continue to help us as we continue through this journey. May his soul rest in peace. Okay, just I don't want to anticlimatically leave here, but Ron, I was saying, he wants this Mr. Central American and Caribbean 11 times, straight in a row. I mean, you see, that's what I'm talking about. But anyway, it is what it is. We would learn from that and move on.
Praise the name of the Lord. Glory to God. Today we have gathered in honor and memory of our dear Brother Bob. Amen? Amen. And the most important thing in this life is the legacy that you left behind. Whether you have a good one or a bad legacy. And for Brother Bob, he left a good legacy. And that's what matters. That's what important. Glory to God. The Bible tells about a story about two men. In Luke 16:19-31. In this life, it's full of choices. We make over 100 decisions each day. We have to decide what time to get up. We have to make a decision on what clothes to wear. Glory to God. For work, I said for home, we have to decide which way to go to work or even to go to work. We have to take care of other things all day long. The choice are always before us. We can never face a day without choices. Glory to God. Where today we have a choice to make. The choice is where we are going to spend eternity. Some of us have made that choice other does not want to think about it. One day that choice will be final. And as we gather in honor of our friend today, we are faced with an important question. Where would we stand eternity? So the Bible tells us about two men. The first man we read about is a rich man. There was a certain rich man who was clothed in purple, fine linen, and fared sumptuously every day. Here we learn a few things about this man. He was rich. He wore good clothes. Yeah. And he lived in luxury every day. This is a man who had everything, money. Goodbye. Come on, somebody. Right. He had taken all of life and lived it to the full. He has no worries. From a woman's perspective, everyone would like to live this way, ain't it? We often wish that we could do anything we wanted to, and go any place we wanted to go without worrying about the cost. Here was that person. He did it his way. He did not need anyone. He was independent. He was wealthy, so he can afford it. Come on, somebody. The second man, but there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, full of soul. He was laid at his gate, desiring to be fed with the crumbs which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dog came and licked his soul. We also learn a few things about the second man. He was a beggar. Come on, somebody. This man, he was a beggar. He begged for whatsoever he needed. He begged for food. He begged for everything. Glory to God. We don't want to say things about him. He had no place to live. So he was a beggar. He had no place to live except on the street. He was sick and full of sore. He was satisfied with the crumbs which fell from the table. His only friends were dogs. And dog was his only medicine help. Here is a man that one really wants to be. He had nothing. He was looked down only by all those around him. He was a friendless. He was friendless. Christ told the story to let people know that there are two types of individuals in this world. Those who depend on themselves, and those who depend on others. This beggar did not trust in God for help and comfort, as we learn from the outcome of his death. Not only did these men drift in their lifestyle, they also differed greatly in their personal choices. All of us have the same choices to make. All of us today in our life have choices to make. Glory to God. So it was that the beggar died, Lazarus. Glory to God. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. And was carried by angel to Abraham's bosom. The beggar Lazarus died, but he had no burial. Come on, somebody. I say he had no burial. Brother, but have a burial here today. He looked very good. Come on, somebody. Amen. But the beggar has no burial. Glory to God. He was carried by angel. Amen. To this place of comfort. Also referred to as Abraham's bosom. We learn later that this is a place called paradise. By Christ. Paradise or Abraham's bosom. It is a place for those who believe in Jesus Christ. To save them from the punishment of sin and give their life to him as the Lord. Lazarus made this choice. What choice have you to make today? What choice will you make today? The rich man also died, the Bible tells us. And he was buried. He had a funeral service. Come on, somebody. Because he can't afford it. He was rich. He was wealthy. So he can't afford a funeral service. And in hell he lifted up his eyes, being in torment. Have mercy on me. And tell Lazarus that he may dip the tip of his finger. Praise your name, Jesus. In water and cool off my tongue. For I am in agony. In worries, come on somebody. In suffering. In pain, come on somebody. Hey, Jesus. Glory to God. For I am in agony, in flame. But Abraham said, child, remember that during your life, come on somebody, you received your good things. You was wealthy and rich. You can afford it. And like Lazarus, bad things. But now he's been comforted here. And you are in agony. And besides all this, between us and you, there is a great gulf fixed. In order that those who wish to come over here from here to you may not be able. And that none may cross over from there to us. And he said, then I beg you, Father Abraham, that you send him to my father's house. For I have 5 brethren, that he may warn them, that they also come to this place of torment. But Abraham said, they have Moses, and they have the prophet.
Yes.
Come on, somebody, have the preachers.
Yes.
Let them hear them. But he said, no, Father Abraham. But if someone goes to them from the dead, they will repent. But he said to him, if they do not listen to Moses and the prophet, neither will they be persuaded if someone risen from the dead. So the rich man also died. He has a funeral. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
He buried. The rich man goes to a place called hell. Come on.
Yes.
Which is a place of torment. While he is there, the rich man wants mercy. He quickly learned that after death there is no mercy.
No mercy.
We have a choice to make today. Yes. He also learned from Abraham that the Bible is the only source of learning about life, about death. Most of all, he learned that the choice made in life affects our eternal life. The choice that you make today will affect you tomorrow. He ignored the scripture, the book that directs us to Jesus in eternal life. Many times, people reject the word of God. Glory to God. But one of these days, all of us, gonna stand before God to give account of our life. What choice did we make? How we live our life? And God is a fair God. He gave every man a payment. I said, you get paid for whether you live good or whether you live bad. So God will pay all those who live good and all those who live bad. The devil will pay. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Glory to God. Each one here today has a choice to make concerning eternity. We have chosen to believe in Jesus Christ. Following him as Lord, that we can live for ourselves with no hope for the future. But we have a hope today. We chosen Jesus Christ. Then there need to be a change. That including confession of sin. And believe in the gospel of Christ. This gospel tells us that Christ died on the cross. For you. For me. For our sins. Come on, somebody. He was buried and he rose from the dead. To show us the way to heaven. If you want to know the Lord. I say if you want to meet Jesus. Christ, your personal friend today, right where you are, right in this place, right now, right here. There are hope for you.
That's right.
Only believe. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
Look at the times we are living in. We are living in serious times. Challenges. Come on, somebody. In crisis we are living in. come on somebody. Hey, come on somebody. What more important? Even though your life is right in God, you have a place of rest. Come on somebody. You have a choice. All of us have a choice to make today. Where will you spend your eternity? If Brother Bob walk with the Lord, we know that one of these days we will see him again.
That is true.
We have the confidence. We have the hope to see him again. But we can only see him again if we make that good choice today. To accept the Lord into our life. Family members today, I want to encourage you. If you don't know the Lord, try to know him now. Make the Lord your choice. Make him your choice. Today is the day of salvation. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
Tomorrow is too late. Tomorrow is too late. They claim that this Delta is very real. It's very serious. It took one of my uncle's son away. 44 years old. Come on, somebody. We people need the Lord. People need the Lord. I said, people need the Lord. Time is running out on us. People need the Lord. What do you want in hell? What in hell do you want? I'm talking to somebody. What in hell you really want? What is there for you? What in there? What is there in hell for you? What you want there? Come on, somebody. Make the Lord Jesus Christ your choice. And my encouragement, hey Jesus, my encouragement to you today. Family members, bind together. We have a thing in us that when someone from a father dead, family done. When mother dead, family done. No! Bind together and strengthen each other. Comfort each other. Hallelujah. People need people. And people need the Lord. Hallelujah. So my encouragement to us today is to accept the Lord. Make the Lord your choice. Is the best thing. Come on, somebody. Is the best gift. You can't give to yourself. Come on. Is the best gift. Is to make the Lord your choice. Take him. The Bible tells us, let God be your refuge. Come on, somebody. He will shelter you in danger. In this corona, I say, come on. He will shelter you. In difficulty, he will be there for you. In trouble. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Make the Lord your choice.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Make him your choice today. Have hope in the Lord. Not like this rich man who believed because he was wealthy and he had money. He's a macho man. Hallelujah. But be humble. Let Lazarus come on somebody. And bow at Jesus' feet today. Kneel at his feet today. And accept him into your life. Stand with me this morning. Glory to God.
Just as I am without one thing, God, my love, was there for me, and that salvation comes to me. Oh,
We should not wait for another opportunity. It may not come. It may not come. Today, if you would hear his voice, said the Holy Ghost, harden not your heart. You have said a lot of things that I would continue to ponder upon and would help others. I wanted to sit like you in the audience, but I was asked to sit up here. The Spirit of the Living God is tugging away at the heart of everybody. Mr. Bobby's not coming back to get another opportunity. The rich man didn't get any more opportunity. And one of the things the preacher said, I never thought about that. There was a burial for the rich man, maybe in fine style, but Lazarus did not need to be buried. I never thought about that point. But while you ponder on what you have heard, I'm just assisting here now to make this altar call on the Lord's behalf for your soul. Will you bow your heads, please, and let us pray. Lord Jesus, we're told we can come to you. Your word says, him that cometh unto me, I will in no wise cast out, regardless to what we have done. You say that if we come to you, you will not cast us out. We do not come as boasters today, Lord, but we come as Darkey would have said, as humble people, not boasting our achievements, but thanking you for your grace. Have mercy upon us and save us today. Just say that simple prayer, Lord Jesus, I need you. Have mercy upon me. Come into my heart and save me. Prepare me for eternity. So while I live, I will not live for myself, but I will live for you who died for me. Thank you for hearing my prayer. Amen. Family members, I'm asked to pray for you. His dear wife in 1974 and counting, 1974 and counting, she's been under my ministry. It's a woman I appreciate very much. I used to call her Fatso. She had more flesh. But according to one of the speakers, she's always been loving and kind and the whole family. We want to pray for you. The pastor requests that I pray for the family. So I want to do that now. Prayer works wonders. There's no need to separate. Let her stay where she is. It's okay. There's no need to separate from each other. I wish I could tell you join hands. But I'm not going to tell you that. But I'm going to ask you just to have a humble heart before God. And in this time of great bereavement, oh God, the loss of a loved one, let them know that for those who have accepted Christ, the future is as bright as the promises of God. For his wife especially, I pray at this time. Many years they have lived together. Give her the comfort that only can come from you. Bless the children. Help them to support each other. And let the family be closer, knit together than before. We just want to thank you now for all that you have promised you will do. In Jesus' wonderful name. Amen. Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. This time, my brother, Brother Alan, at this time, for the closing prayer, our Father's prayer.
Praise. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, your power, and your glory, forever and ever. And all God's people say, Amen.
On behalf of my mom, my brother and sister, brothers and sisters overseas, thank you all for coming out, our relatives and friends, many too much to mention. But we want to thank you all for being here with us today, despite all this corona thing. We thank you for coming out. And after the service, the family would like to grieve privately, please. But we appreciate you for being here. Thank you all very much. Thank you, Pastor. Thank you, Pastor Lee. Thank you all very much.
Sing the wonders of Jesus. Sing His mercy.
Sing the song.
When we all get to heaven,
what a day!
What a day of rejoicing! And that's when we
all,
when we all see
Mas que é uma... When? No, I'm not going to be in the car.
No, I'm doing sorry.
Just tell the woman in the car. Just tell the woman in the car. Just tell the woman in the car. Just tell the woman in the car.
Come on the other side. Yeah, come on, right.
You're talking all kinds of things, this and that. Are you sure about you see me? You take it, you say you're killed.
I know I'm not dropping anybody, but I need to drop it.
Let me take
over here.
Put your hand.
Wait. Turn in.
All you see is me now.
So I could
have stone one time.
Ready?
Just
turn
around. Turn around. Use your hand.
Use your hand and turn around.
Go on.
I have to let let go behind and send it wrong, eh?
Go on.
You know, the dead bearing people, so you know, they have to protect the gutter side, you know.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing His mercy and His grace. In the mansion, bright and pleasant, He prepared for us a place.
Come on.
When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory.
Oh, when we all get to heaven,
what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. Hallelujah. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. Oh, when we all
still tell me
what a day of rejoicing that will be. Hallelujah. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. Hallelujah. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. Oh, when you get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. Hallelujah. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. Oh, when we all get to heaven.
We gather here today to celebrate the life and the death of our loved one. Eternal God is your refuge, and underneath are your everlasting arms. He will trust all the enemy before you. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring with Him those who have fallen asleep. In Jesus' name.
For this we say to you by the word of the Lord, that we are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord. While we'll by no means precede those who are asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of archangel, with the trump of God. And the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the cloud to meet the Lord in the air. And thus we will always be with the Lord. We have gathered here to commit to rest the body of our loved one and friend. Here is the form of one whose memory we shall treasure. Some of us have shared through these passing years a wonderful companionship with our loved one. Let us cherish the many memories that come to us at this time, and let each of us here purpose to seek the Lord with our whole heart and respond to the opportunity of salvation extended to us through his grace. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? We then as workers together with him also plead with you to receive the grace of God in vain. Not in vain, for he says in an acceptable time, I have heard you. In the day of salvation, I have helped you. Behold, now is the accepted time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Earth to earth. Ashes to ashes. Father, we gather in this solemn place to remember the life and mourn the death of our loved one. We ask that you will comfort each family members and friend. May they turn to your word for comfort. Be encouraged through happy memories and purpose in their heart to seek you while they may be found in Jesus' name. Glory to God. Oh, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. Oh, when we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. Sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing his mercy and his grace. In their mansion, bright and blessed, he prepared for us a place.
Come on.
When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. Hallelujah. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. While we walk the pilgrim pathway, cloud will over spread the sky. But when traveling days are over, not a shadow, not a sign.
Come on.
When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. Let us then be true and faithful, trusting, serving every day. Just one glimpse of him in glory will the ties of life repay. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. Hallelujah. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory. Onward to the right before us, soon his beauty will behold. Soon the pearly gates will open, we shall tread the streets of gold. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory.
When we all
get to heaven,
What a day of rejoicing that will be. Oh, when we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory.
Will your anchor hold in the storms of life? When your clouds and fall, their wings are swept. When the strong tempest gives us in, will your anchor to us remain? We have an anchor that keeps us whole. Save us and show why the billows roll. Pass into the road, which cannot hold. One will come and be in the Savior's love. When your anchor holds in the strength of Him, when the breakers flow and the reef is near, when the sudden rain and the wild wind blow, start the angry wind. We have an anchor that keeps our soul steadfast and sure while the billows roll. Pass into the rock which cannot move. One will come and hear in the Savior's word. In the anchor in the flood of sin, when the waters continually rising tide, never through, where the anchor holds in your hand. We have an anchor that keeps us strong, sets us strong where the billows roll. Cast into the rock which cannot hold, and therefore in the Savior.
Do you have any fun with Dr. Singh?
love to sing in the song? They love to sing. You have any song that he loved to sing?
Yeah.
What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we have been forfeited. Oh, what meanness pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Temptation, is there trouble anywhere? We shall never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Who my friend is Christ for safety. Oh, take it to the Lord in prayer. In His arms He take and shield thee. The way find the soul is there. Have you a passport? Have you a passport? Have you a passport to heaven? If you don't have one, go out and get one. Have you a passport? Have you a passport? Have you a passport? Have you a passport to heaven? If you don't have one, go out and get one. Have you a passport? Have you a passport? Have you a passport? Have you a passport? If you don't have one, go and get one. Have you a passport? Have you a passport? Have you a passport? Have you a passport to heaven? If you don't have one, go out and get one. Have you a passport? Oh, you can do it. Far and wide, S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O-N. Far and wide, S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O-N. Yes, you can go to heaven without S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O-N. To heaven with us. S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O-N. Shout it out. S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O-N. Shout it out loud and clear. S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O-N.
Shout it out.
S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O-N. Shout it out loud and clear. S-A-L-V-A-T-I-O-N.
Two little children was walking one day down by the fair river side. One of them turned to the boatman and said, row me over the tide. Row me over the tide.
children was walking one day down by the ferry pastime. One of them turned to the boat man and said, "Roll me over the side, roll me over the side, Lord, my boat, roll me over the side. Love was a waiting for me over there. Roll me over the tide, roll me over the tide. Loved ones are waiting for me over there. Roll me over the tide. It is all right, all right. It is all right, all right. As long as I have my Lord beside me. It is all right. As long as I have his hands to hold, as long as he watches over my soul, as long as I'm under his control, it is all right. It is all right, all right. It is all right, all right. As long as I have my love beside me, it is all right. As long as I have his hand to hold, and he watches over my soul. He's under his control. It is all right. It is all right. All right. It is all right. All right. As I have my Lord beside me, it is all right. Long as I have his hand to hold, and he watches over my soul. He's under his control. It is all right. Strong warrior, with me weapon in my right hand. I am a warrior, strong warrior, with me weapon in my right hand. Warrior, warrior. Christian warrior, oh, with me weapon, in me right hand. Oh, I'm a warrior, a Christian warrior, oh, with me weapon, in me right hand. Warrior, warrior,
warrior, warrior, warrior, warrior.
Crown him with roses to wear.
Jesus loved to hear little children sing. We will crown him with roses to wear. Oh, we will crown him with roses. Crown him with roses. Crown him with roses to wear. Oh, we will crown him with roses. Crown him with roses. Crown him with roses to wear.
For you.
Yeah. We will crown him with roses. Crown him with roses.
It just stretch and we'll get a type and took it.
Yes,
Duru! Yeah,
let's crown him with roses. Crown him with roses. Crown him with roses to
wear. You can do it over differently.
If I had a sleep on me, love, sleep on and take a rest. Lay down your head upon the Savior's breast. We love you, yes, but Jesus loves you best. Good night, good night, good night.
Oh, good day.
Boy,
sorry. Good day, good day, good day, good day, good day.
Take care of the flowers, let me know.
Like the flowers.
And you. But Jesus loves you.
Good day, good day, good day.
The weather is about to change, so we have to cut everything down.
I know, inspection, I know, umbrella.